Hi there. In this tutorial, we are going to migrate Flutter blog from version 6 to version 8, which is currently the latest one. The link of the source code is in the description. Like the video, subscribe, and don't miss my future real projects. Here are all dependencies. Now let's introduce our little counter project that uses multi-block provider and hydrated block overrides. This button increases and another one decreases the number. Using block listener, block provider, in the other page you can see also the number. And it also detects connectivity changes. If your connection type is Wi-Fi, it increases the counter value by 1. And if your phone is disconnected, you will get disconnected message. And the last one, if your connection type is mobile, it decreases the counter value by 1. It has also a setting page, and using block overrides we can debug all of the block and qubit states. Here current state of the counter value is 6 and next state is 7. When you press the increase button, qubit detects current state and then the number is increased by 1. That's why you will see increased number as the next stage, and so on. Here also you can see setting state changes. Current state of app notification is false and next state is true. That's all, and now let's migrate it to Flutter blog version 8. First, we need to update all dependencies. For that, I have PubSpec Assist extension, which is very helpful to update or add new dependencies. And use it by pressing Ctrl+Shift+P shortcut and search PubSpec Assist and press enter. Type dependency name that you want to add or update. For example, type Flutter block and it updates. In this way we update all dependencies. Insert them separating with comma. As you can see, you can update several dependencies at once. After that, run Flutter pub get. And now we are in the new version of the dependencies, so we have some errors. Let's migrate it. In custom block observer class, here instead of qubit, we have to write block base. On event, we have to care null safety. And we have to write just block, not block base. Because on event and on transition are belong to block, not qubit. And that's all with observer class. Here in the main class, block.observer is deprecated. Instead, we use block_overrides.runs on it. And let's stop and rerun the application. Here implement your own block observer class. If you want to store your data to local memory, you can store it by hydrated storage. In my case, I implement it also. For that, here just use hydrated block observer and show its storage. After hot restart, it's not reset to zero. The link of the source code is in the description. Like, subscribe, and don't miss my future real projects. And thank you for watching.